Good afternoon, everybody out there. It is a rainy Thursday afternoon here in British Columbia, and I am taking five from the current talk that I am producing, coming up with. Anyway, to talk a little bit about a talk that I did earlier this week in Vancouver, and a question that comes up for me all the time that people sort of never seem to tire of wondering about. So I thought I would do a super quick tutorial on why sex in the animal kingdom is so gosh darn difficult for the most part. Here, you guys, is an egg. It's an egg. And it's really big. And it's really expensive. And females, especially, you know, human females, don't have that many of them to go around. Human females drop one of these once a month, and if that one happens to get fertilized, they will be out of reproductive commission for a further, you know, 9 months, at least, at the very least. Now, what is this? They're so small, you can't even see it. Oh, yeah. That would be sperm. So for every ejaculate out there, every ejaculate, that means every single ejaculate, there is tens of millions of sperms. And so conceivably, pun very much intended, one single man could fertilize millions of women with one single ejaculate if we had a way of, you know, separating out all of those single cells and getting each one into the uterus of a receptive female. But the point is this. Sperm is abundant and cheap. Eggs are expensive, and there are very few of them to come by. And so this often leads to very different strategies for approaching sex between males and females. In fact, love really is a battlefield. Pat Benetar said it best. She said it right. She knows. There's a lot of discourse between males and females in the animal kingdom, including within humans, but I suppose that's a talk for another day.